This is Jeff, 29 years old. He developed an extreme itching over the last few days. He suddenly notices a small rash on his leg, but not itchy. But his abdomen is very itchy, without rash, and he has no allergy. He also has GERD, or gastroesophageal reflux disease, a few years ago. After CT scan and ultrasound, the doctor found out that he has a mild fatty liver and hiatal hernia. Alkaline phosphatase level is high after blood work. He experienced sharp pain in the upper right abdomen. He drinks alcohol only once a week and not on any medications. He likes to eat fried food very much, especially pork daily. What can be the cause of his itchiness? Itchiness is a broad topic, but we can simplify it to only two causes. Itchiness caused by the outer source. And itchiness caused by inner source. Itchiness caused by the outer source is when you put something on skin surface, and it feels itchy immediately or later. The management of this is easier, because you see exactly what you put on your skin before the itch. You only need to eliminate the cause. Itchiness caused by inner source is when the itchiness just appears on its own, even you don't put anything on the skin surface. This is more challenging to manage, because you don't exactly see what causes it before the itchiness. With this cause, we could look into what's going on inside our body. Something wrong with his organs and blood. The sudden rash appear on Jeff's leg is very significant. And if we look on his diet, though he rarely drinks alcohol, he eats a lot of fatty foods every day. There are two types of fatty liver, alcoholic and non-alcoholic. Jeff's case is non-alcoholic, because he eats a lot of fatty foods, and it's related more about his diet. Since he has no allergies, we could eliminate skin disorders. His real problem is something to do inside his body, organs and blood. Let's take a look at pathophysiology of Jeff's extreme itchiness. The fate of fats is the following. Healthy and enough amount of fat will be emulsified by bile from liver and digested by pancreatic lipase to break it down into smallest unit as fatty acids, ready to be absorbed on the small intestine, specifically on upper jejunum. Then it goes to the bloodstream to be utilized by the body. These fatty acids will also be used by the brain to function well, which contains 60% fatty acids. Most unhealthy fats like dairy, cheese, and fats from fried foods will not be absorbed by the small intestine, but goes to large intestine for excretion. The presence of fat in the stool is called steatorrhea. But if your body cannot excrete these unhealthy fats, excessive fats will be stored in the liver or in adipose tissue. Adipose tissue is also called subcutaneous tissue or hypodermis. This is your skin layer. This is the hypodermis, where stored fats are located. In order to explain the small rash on his leg, the liver produces approximately 600 to 1,200 milliliters of yellow-green bile daily. Bile contains water, bilirubin, cholesterol, certain products of organic metabolism and bile salts. Liver forms approximately 0.6 milliliters of bile salts daily. Only bile salts which are formed from cholesterol are important in digestion. The liver must constantly remove bile salts from the blood. If this is not done, bile salts begin collecting in tissues all our body. Approximately 94% of bile salts that enter the intestine are reabsorbed into the portal circulation by an active transport process that takes place in the distal ileum. Through portal circulation, bile salts pass into the liver, where they are recycled. Normally, bile salts travel this entire circuit approximately 18 times before being expelled in the feces. Fatty liver is the accumulation of fats in the liver cells. From the case of Jeff, since the bile salts are not reabsorbed in the liver and not excreted through digestive organs, it goes to blood. The blood would try to expel it through other avenue of elimination, such as skin. Because of additional bile salts present in the circulation, it creates pressure, resulting in which blood seeps out of the vessels, producing discoloration or rash. However, Jeff's abdomen is very itchy, without rash. Internal organs like liver are connected by reflex nerves. In most instances, the area they are connected with is the skin surface, directly above that organ. This could be the reason why only the abdomen part of Jeff is itchy, but not the other part of the body. It also means that his itchiness is in the early stage, since he experiences it locally, it means the bile salts are not distributed throughout his body. The free nerve ending in the dermis is called the itch receptor, which detects itch caused by bile salts. We call it Mrgpr receptor, as itch receptor for bile. Jeff's alkaline phosphatase level is high. Alkaline phosphatase is an enzyme present in the bile duct. When the level of it is high, it means there is a reduced bile flow, due to conditions that block it, such as fatty liver, making bile accumulate in the blood. Jeff experienced sharp pain in the upper right abdomen. This is where our liver located. We need to look into his liver in order to address his itchiness. He drinks alcohol only once a week and not on any medications. So his condition is non-alcoholic fatty liver. And it is mostly related to diet, since he likes to eat fried food, especially pork daily. Jeff's slight fatty liver can cover up spaces of liver cells, including bile duct, making the reabsorption of bile salts less effective. So bile salts go back to blood circulation and accumulate there. Bile salts in the blood can hinder continuous and quick circulation. So, the body is making a way to eliminate it through other avenue of elimination, which is the skin. So what's the solution of Jeff's problem? 1. Avoid trans fats and animal fat like fried foods, pork and other meat like beef. 2. Take artichoke. It decreases liver fat production and increases excretion. 3. Take turmeric. Its anti-inflammatory action protects liver from further damage like liver cirrhosis. 4. Take chlorella. Helps balance cholesterol and sugar levels in the blood. 5. Lemon. Lemon and the liver are sweethearts. The lemon is one of the best friends that the liver has. 6. Avoid refined sugars, do not overeat, and try to lose weight. The liver cannot store too much sugar as glycogen. As a result, the liver will convert them into fat that will be deposited into the hypodermis of the skin if the body has the problem of eliminating fats. This is the reason why diabetic person can also experience itchiness. People with chronic renal disease can also experience itchiness as they cannot properly eliminate fats from body. Another cause of itchiness is someone who has problem with blood, like anemia. If you find this video helpful, please like and share. And don't forget to subscribe.
To learn more, get the full course. This course will give you a complete understanding on how our body function in order to cure your illness today in a simple and holistic manner.